Hey, what's going on? Bill is Krosama here. So we take a look at the new event that just dropped. This is going to be called the Golden Ace, featuring the Hyakushiki, piloted by Shar Aznable. So I am actually I was at a middle ground right now. I'm not super excited, but I'm not like disappointed because I do like the Hyakushiki. So this is definitely going to be a mobile suit I am going to be pulling on. And I will try to give y'all analysis sometime tomorrow if possible. I do have a lot on my plate right now that I do want to like make some different videos, especially things covering Gunpla as well as just different Plamo. So just stay with me for a little bit. I will be getting the Hyakushiki analysis out to you guys. But let's go ahead and take a look at the actual event. Okay, well, looking at the front banner, obviously you are going to have the Hyakushiki, and you're going to have different mobile suits, and the parts of these mobile suits actually add on a multiplier. So if you have the Tall Geese 2, which was from the last event, or you have a Hyakushiki part, that is a 2x multiplier on the coins that will drop from these actual missions. And then you're going to have the Shenlong as well as the Death Scythe. So the Shenlong is going to be a 5x multiplier, and then the Death Scythe is going to be a 7x multiplier. Now those two mobile suits in particular, those are going to be drops from the banner, both a default 4-star, so it might be a little bit difficult for you to actually get them, but good luck on your pulls. Now here are the missions. So we're going to have the first one, which is going to be a 5 energy use normal mission. This one is going to have some achievements that's going to come with it. Now you move over here to the hard Golden Ace. This one, 15 energy use. Once again, you're going to have its own set of achievements. Very hard is going to have its own set of achievements, and energy use is going to be 25. Then you go down here to super hard Golden Ace, which is the first time we've had a super hard Golden Ace. Now, the one big difference is that the very hard is actually labeled hard as far as difficulty, but then the super hard Golden Ace is labeled very hard. But I've already done all those. They're actually not hard whatsoever. Just understand what mobile suits to bring in. And lastly, we are going to have the EX Golden Ace. Now, this one's going to be very hard. Energy use is going to be 45, and approximate combat power is going to be recommended, 100,000. Whereas, you really don't need that much. I mean, I've beaten EX modes with like 75,000. I lost maybe a couple of times, but it is doable to win. Sometimes you gotta like be a little cheap with it and cheese your way through it by just shooting the enemies. But I would tell you right now, I don't think this one's going to be too hard. Now for the enemies, pretty much for the most part, you're going to be having the GMs. You do have the, I forgot old boy's name. I don't know if you can long hold on it, but yeah, I think it's the Rick Diaz. I think that's one. That's what that one is. Then you also obviously the boss is going to be the Hyakushiki. Now the Hyakushiki is going to be a P attribute. So your preferred attribute is going to be speed. So I'm using the new Gundam. Obviously, it's going to have an extra damage increase whenever you're attacking the Hyakushiki. So that's the reason I would choose that. I would definitely say avoid using technique because you're going to be at a disadvantage against the Hyakushiki. And you really don't want to be taking any extra unnecessary damage. So definitely if you have any kind of speed attribute mobile suits, much like, the Blitz is a good one. The new Gundam is a good one. There's quite a few other ones. I think, if I'm not mistaken, the Rising is also one. So we could take a look right now because I have a bunch of them right here. Yeah, the Rising is going to be a speed type and the Sumo is going to be a speed type. So you are going to have different mobile suits at your arsenal so that way you can bring them into the match and actually have a much easier time facing the Hyakushiki. Now for the achievements, you are going to be getting one AI Awakening Circuit whenever you clear 20 of the event missions very hard. And with completing 20 of the super hard missions, you'll be getting a normal parts awakening circuit. So yeah, it's kind of sucky that you're only getting one of each, but you're also still going to have the ones that's going to be in the shop with the exchange that you can go ahead and exchange some of these coins for to get these drops. Okay, and here we are in the shop. So you're going to have all these Hyakushiki parts. We're going to just take a look at them. Obviously, we can't do any kind of like maxing, but in my analysis, I'm going to go way more in depth in this. But yeah, this is going to have the Vulcans. Then we're going to take a look at the body. Do a long hold. So this one's going to have the parts trait, and it's with Ace Excel, enemy melee damage taken reduced by 6. Yeah, I'm not really too fond of that. And for the arms, is going to be unleash a combo with the saber in your right hand. And for the legs, you're going to have a parts trait with bazooka category equipped, shot spread reduced 6%. So, yeah, that's actually not too bad. And with the backpack, the parts trait is with Ace Excel enemy, the shooting power is going to be boosted 8%. So that's actually really damn good. You're definitely going to want extra firepower if necessary. And for your Beam Saber, you're going to have basically a pretty okay EX skill. It's going to be a B+ power, which isn't too bad. But thrust your charge sword to cleave cleanly through foes, lowers hit enemies, Gunpla's beam resistance by 20%. So, you know what? I think that's pretty okay, and it looks like they put an extra space behind the apostrophe and the S. So, yeah. Now for the gun, you're going to have when attacking with beam EX power, when attacking with beam, I forgot that they segregate these kind of lines, but when you are attacking with a beam type weapon, your EX skill power is going to be boosted 8%, so that's really damn good. I don't really know what the max of the shot attack is, so this may be a really good beam rifle to for you to use out of the default 3 stars. Obviously, you're going to want to boost in your attack, and that is only a level 1 at 8%, so it might go to like maybe 17, maybe even 20% at level 10. And with the Clay Bazooka, you are going to have dual wave, so a physical shot, be negative on, or be minus on the piercing, and just basically hold bazookas in both hands and fire high-powered rounds. So, yeah, it's pretty okay. It kind of reminds me of the Camphor's ability, so, you know what, not really too bad. And for the rest, you are going to have a lot of the default things. You're going to have a lot of these upgrade parts. You are going to have one Awakening Circuit, which I'm almost enough to go ahead and buy that so I can do another 5-star upgrade. You're going to have another AI Awakening Circuit. I've been kind of hoarding those, so I don't really have any AI pilots I really want to upgrade at the moment. I might actually do my Amuro, but yeah, other than him, I don't really have too many other guys. But other than that, you are going to have some nice emblems. It's going to be from Anaheim Electronics, and just basically going to be like the Hyakushiki symbol. So I really do like these emblems. These are going to be some that I'm going to use for some of my main mobile suits, namely like the white, this one over here. I'm definitely going to be wanting to use that Hyakushiki symbol for mine. But yeah, Anaheim Electronics, I really do like that company because they're such a neutral company within the war. They kind of like produce things for both factions. So I really do like that, and I'll probably be throwing some of those on a couple of my mobile suits. But yeah, for the most part, I mean, like I mentioned before, if you're going to tackle this these missions, but make sure you're bringing a S-type mobile suit. Don't rush in there with a technique. If you're going to go in there with anything outside of speed, go in there with another power or go in there with an all-rounder so that way you're not taking any extra unnecessary damage. And what I would say focus on in the coin exchange, so far just from the top of my head, I would probably go with the backpack and I would go with the beam rifle. Those two are probably going to be your top priorities. I think that that backpack with the extra shooting power is amazing, and that beam rifle is actually really good as well. And then you're obviously going to want to get the purple Awakening Circuits for both AI and the normal. And I usually grab a normal Awakening Circuit for the 3-star because I kind of don't get too many of those. So I'll probably just snag up one of those and sacrifice, you know, buying one of like maybe the Hyakushiki heads because don't really need like 15. I could probably just get away with having 9 of those. But yeah, that's all for me, guys. So definitely thank you for watching. I'm really just not feeling this banner, nor am I really feeling this this event. But it's also just good to get some of these items that we need, especially the Awakening Circuits. That's kind of like what I really do these events for anyways. But really, I kind of wish they would kind of span these out maybe a day or so. Like, give us a day or two break, just that way we can gather a couple more resources and then get ready for the banner. Otherwise, I would say this is still going to be an event that you want to tackle, but maybe not try and pull for a 7x multiplier. If you want to pull maybe 1 time on the banner, and if you don't get anything, then hey, just continue on with a 2x multiplier and you should still be fine. But really, that's all I have for this. I would just say have fun with it, man. Don't take it too seriously. We're going to have another event next week, and if you want to skip this one entirely, you can do that as well. But yeah, that's it for me, guys. If you can, right up there where it says new type, check out their website if you really want to get some good Gunpla. I'm pretty sure they are going to have some of the things that you're really going to be looking for. If you are more on the UC side, the G Gundam side, Gundam Wing, they're definitely going to have it, as well as other different tools, supplies, paints. But yeah, go ahead, check them out. Use that promo code Krosama so that way you can get 10% off your purchases. And definitely get into the Gunpla scene if you haven't already. But I'll be seeing you guys later in the next video. Bye-bye.